To worship this first Sunday of Christmas. It's great that you can join with us today. And Father God, as we gather together to worship you, to praise you, to thank you for your goodness, to listen to your word, and to be inspired by your Holy Spirit today, would you be with us wherever we are, wherever we are listening from today, that the name of Jesus might be glorified in us and through us, we pray. Amen. So glad that you could join with us today. Let's use these opening phrases. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
All creation gives you praise. You alone are truly great. You alone are God who reigns for eternity.
First Sunday of Christmas, so glad that you could join with us. Today the Phillips family are going to be doing our readings. We've got Rev Julie who's going to be bringing us God's word today, so lots to look forward to. Let's join in song, shall we?
Light up the world, treasure of heaven, brilliant like the stars in the wintry sky. Joy of the Father, reach through the darkness, shine across the earth, send the shadows to fly. Light up the world from the beginning, the tragedy of time were no match for your love. From great heights of glory, you saw my story. God, you entered in and became with fire in his eyes. He will ransom his own. Through clouds he will lead us straight into glory, and there he shall reign.
Collect prayer for today is this. Almighty God, who wonderfully created us in his own image and yet more wonderfully restored us through his Son Jesus Christ, grant that just as he came to share in our humanity, so we may share his life of divinity, him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So I'm going to hand over... I'm going to hand over to Ben and Vicky Phillips as they bring us our readings for today.
Today's reading is from Isaiah 61, verses 10 to 62, verse 3. I delight greatly in the Lord. My soul rejoices in my God. For he has clothed me with garments of salvation, and arrayed me in a robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom adorns his head like a priest, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the soil makes the sprout come up, and a garden causes seeds to grow, so the sovereign Lord will make righteousness and praise spring up before all nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not remain quiet. Till her righteousness shines out like the dawn, her salvation like a blazing torch. The nations will see your righteousness, and all kings your glory. You will be called by a new name, and the mouth of the Lord will bestow. You will be a crown of splendour in the Lord's hand, a royal diadem in the hand of your God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our gospel reading for today, Luke 2, verses 15 to 21. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you for that. And now, the one and only Reverend Julie Marshall is going to explain God's word to us. Let's just pray for a second. Father, thank you for Reverend Julie. Thank you for all that she's prepared for us today. We're trusting that you've placed your words in her heart. So would you now give us ears to hear what you would want to say to us today? Amen. Thanks, Reverend Julie.
Last week, we read of the birth of the Christ child. And this week, our scripture points us to the angel and the shepherds. Shepherds are often considered very lowly, but there is a lot of skill and know-how that goes into being a shepherd. And this skill is often passed on from generation to generation. God himself seems to have a soft spot for shepherds. He even identifies himself as the good shepherd. And of course, Psalm 23 begins with, "The Lord is my shepherd." And so God himself identifies with shepherds. And the shepherds play a significant role in the Christmas story. The angel came to them and said, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour who is the Messiah, the Lord." But what puzzled me when I was first preparing my talk was, why was this wonderful revelation given to shepherds and not to the good and the great in Israel at that time? Now, if I had been the angelic angel advising the good Lord, I would have respectfully suggested that if you wanted to make a maximum impact, well, conventional wisdom would dictate that you make a big splash with the good and the great in the land. Forget the shepherds, I would say. You don't want to get involved with them. After all, shepherds had a bad reputation in Jesus' day. They weren't the sort of people you'd want proclaiming anything, let alone the birth of God's one and only Son. After all, shepherds were considered unclean. Their line of work prevented them from taking part in the feasts and holy days that made up the Jewish religious calendar. And when everybody else was making the trip to Jerusalem to make sacrifices at the temple or to take part in one of the annual feasts, shepherds had to be out in the fields watching over the sheep. And shepherds were also looked on with suspicion. They were constantly on the move, and they had rather an endearing quality of confusing what was thine with what is mine, meaning they were renowned for thieving. If it wasn't bolted down when the shepherds came to town, then you'd lost it. And if something went missing, it was always those pesky shepherds again. And you could not trust the word of a shepherd. They were prone to be, let's just put it like this, economical with the truth. And so they were not allowed to act as witnesses in a court of law because their word was not considered trustworthy. Shepherds were implied to be rough, uneducated men. They were accustomed to a hard life. Most of the time, they were living out in the fields. They were with the sheep 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They watched while the sheep grazed. They had to keep an eye out for predators like wolves, and they were pretty skillful with a sling. And at night, they actually slept with the sheep in the sheep pen to guard against theft and animal attack. Most shepherds were illiterate and unrefined, and people in the cities looked down on the shepherding life. They were on the borderline of being social outcasts. And yet, God sent them a revelation about the birth of Jesus, these unreliable witnesses. And why? Well, I think because God is not interested in who you are in the eyes of the world, or what your station in life is, or even what your job is. Because Jesus is interested in where your heart is. What happened when the good and the great, like King Herod, got to hear about Jesus' birth? Did they come and worship? No. The Bible records that when the good and the great got in on the act, they tried to kill Jesus instead. The shepherds, on the other hand, once they had heard of Jesus' birth, went to see Jesus. They visited Mary and Joseph and Jesus in the manger and went on their way, praising God and glorifying God. I believe the message of the shepherds this morning is that for Jesus, no one is beyond the pale. We all come to Jesus on an equal footing. It doesn't matter who we are or what we have achieved. What matters is what is in our hearts. The shepherds went away praising and glorifying God. Herod, on the other hand, went away bitter, murderous, and hateful. Jesus was a threat to society because he came to reconcile to God both the rich and the poor, the socialites and the outcasts. God is as interested in those outside the community of faith as he is interested in those within the community of faith. So let us give thanks to God this Christmas for Jesus. And let us resolve to walk hand in hand with him through our journey here on earth, praising and glorifying God, just as those shepherds did more than 2,000 years ago. Amen.
Thank you so much, Rev Julie. Let's just bring some of those thoughts to prayer, shall we? Father God, we thank you for your word to us today through Rev Julie, and may your words take root deep in our hearts and affect our choices, our lives, our actions and our reactions, we pray. As we gather for worship, we intercede and we stand in the gap, Lord, thinking of those areas of our world where people are going hungry, where people are in fear for their lives, people living in war-torn lands, people who are losing family members because of war and conflict. Father God, into those places and into those lives, would you bring your presence and your peace? Lord, we pray for our own nation, for our own government, for all those that make decisions that affect all of us every day. We pray, Lord, that wisdom and justice and truth and integrity would reign in Parliament. Lord, give us the leaders that we need. Lord, work through them for the good of our nation, we pray. And we pray for our own city here in Stoke-on-Trent. We pray for our local council. We pray for our ward councillors and the great relationships that we have with them. Lord, help us to work together to seek the good for all people. Lord, may hope and peace and joy and love overflow from your church, Lord, to our city and to our local communities here in Bucknall and Bentilee and Abbey, Hulton and Eaton Park. And Lord, we pray for those that are close to our hearts, those that are not good today, those that are not well in their state of mind, Lord, those that are ill and struggling in their bodies. We pray that you would bring your healing and your presence and your peace to them In the name above all names we pray, in the name of Jesus. And we draw our prayers together in the words of the Lord's Prayer as we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Well, as we bring our time to a close, may we wish you from all here in the Bucknall team a very good New Year's Eve and a very happy New Year, and praying God's blessing on you for all that he's got for you in the new year. Let's sing together, and then we're going to bring our final blessing. Father, whose blessed Son shared at Nazareth the life of an earthly home, help your church to live as one family, united in love and obedience, and then bring us at last to our home in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So may the hope, the peace, the joy, and the love of Jesus fill your heart this day and as we move into 2024. May God bless you and keep you safe. And may you know his presence in a greater measure in your heart and in your life, I pray. Amen. God bless you and see you in 2024 for Epiphany next week.
For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead.